Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the 9 o'clock Sunday night live show. Here we go. We are ready to go. Oh, I see we got a room full of people in here already. So we're off and running. Let's just do a little bit of... there we go. So, Randy, I added you. We're good to go. Welcome to Sunday night live, 9 p.m. We're talking about the Canon 90D, which is brand new, straight out of the box, from B&H. And let's go over to the other guy. This is the Nikon ZFC, brand new, straight out of the box. So we are ready to rock and roll. All right. So this is both of the cameras. I'm going to show them off. Now, the 90D has been giving me a little bit of problems ever since it came, and I don't know what it is. Yes, I have gone through every little thing that I can think of in the menu, including how responsive it is and how responsive it isn't. So just those of you that do know the 90D menus, we have where you can adjust the responsiveness of the autofocus. So now it's on my face. It's doing okay. I hope it makes a liar out of me, honestly. I hope that it just doesn't act up, because on the Friday Night Live show, which you guys, many of you know, I have a Friday Night Live show, and that is at 10 o'clock Friday night. It's not structured like this one. So this one is designed for me to stay on topic. I don't do all the hellos and finding out what you had for dinner and that kind of stuff here. And this is being recorded as a podcast. So it will be uploaded as a podcast, and you'll hear me stating some things to people who aren't watching, because a podcast is not actually doesn't have a picture. All right, so this is the Canon 90D. So what lens do I have on it? Now, this is a little bit unfair, but it's what I got. All right, so the 90D has got a native Canon brand 50mm 1.8 lens on there. It's the one that's reasonably priced, and I've got it on full autofocus. It's set to tracking for the face. Yes, I made sure I did not do any knuckle tapping. That's what happens to a lot of these cameras, is you'll fiddle faddle around and your knuckle will accidentally create a focus point. No, that's not good. And then you're wondering, why won't it focus properly? So remember the rules for tonight and every night on our live show. If you have a question, you need to put QQQ. I am looking for a QQQ, and the question needs to be pertaining to the 90D or the Nikon ZFC. And that is because I get off track very easily. Yes, I do know people will ask, what microphone are you using? And that's not pertaining to the 90D. So the microphone is actually the Ear Trumpet Labs. Myrtle is the actual brand. All of the choices that you make, all the names that they have come up with. Okay, so let's go into the zoomed in. So this is the Nikon ZFC, and you can compare actually what it looks like compared to the 90D. Now, I'm not going to wait till the end of the show to tell you what my recommendation is. First and foremost, if you have Nikon lenses, buy the Nikon. If you have Canon lenses, buy the Canon. Unless you are willing to switch and change to something else, and in that case, then you are free to buy what you want. But if I were to buy one today, like right now, if I was going to go to the internet and go to B&H, by the way, the links to both cameras are in the down low in the description, in the doobly-doo. So if you want to see what I diddly did, look in the doobly-doo. Okay, so now we're on the Nikon ZFC, and I'm just going to kind of walk to the back to where the tree is. Right next to my little bubble lamps, which I used to have miniature versions of these for Christmas when I was a child. So that was my back, and now I'm going to go over to the side, and I'm going to purposely walk up back to the Christmas desk slowly on the ZFC. All right, so now I'm going to do the same exact thing, but I'm going to switch the camera over to the 90D. So it's not an exact comparison because I don't have a 35 millimeter lens on the 90D. So again, I'm going to go walk to the back of the room and I'm going to not fall down. I promise. Well, I shouldn't promise things like that. All right, so now I'm at the back of the room. This is the Canon D. You can see the bubble lights. Okay, so the bubble lights are designed to attract focus. Then I've got specular lights. Specular lights are the sharp points of light that's on the tree. So these things, you think like, oh, Peter, you have a Christmas set. How cool is that? Well, it is cool. I happen to like Christmas. As a matter of fact, I got some information to tell you about the Christmas CD that's coming. But the specular lights, which means spots of light, okay, on the tree, the bubble lamps, and now, wait, I'm going to go over to the side, okay? All right, and now I'm going to walk up to Myrtle, and I'm going to walk slowly and head towards the desk. And you could watch exactly how the 90D is doing. Now, I have to confess, for some reason, the 90D is brand new out of the box, just came in from B&H Photo, and so did the ZFC. But the 90D likes to jump off of my face for some reason, and I'm looking back there to see what it is. I'm pointing to the background guys, you guys that are watching, listening on the podcast. I know you don't get a picture, so when I say this over here and that over there, that I should remember to say what I'm pointing to, because people are saying people are looking. So let me check. Of course, super chats get top priority, and that is out of courtesy to people that want to donate. And for the super chats tonight, because you're giving a gift to the Christmas room, and you, if you do a super chat, I want to give a present back to you. And you can go over to petergregg.com and pick any particular song that's coming out on my new album. And I will send you the MP3 file for free, just to say thank you. Thank you for supporting me, okay? So that's for the Super Chats, $5 and up. Now, let's take a quick look here. I see people, Lewis, Michael, Randy, all of you guys are saying hello, but I am looking for a QQQ. I don't see any QQQs, no questions. Okay. Okay, so wait, Sammy. Hello, Sammy. Sammy's a friend of mine. So we got a friend asking a friend a question here. Here we go. Sammy Superstar has his own channel, and he's asking question. QQQ, by the way, guys. QQQ, because it attracts my attention. I have to tell you the truth. The QQQ attracts my attention because it's the symbol for the NASDAQ. Okay, so Sammy says, if you could use only one camera, would you use the Canon 90D or would you use the Nikon ZVF? That is the question from Sammy. Sammy, I want to say it up front at the beginning of the show and not make everybody string along to the end as to which camera I would choose. I would definitely, okay, no lenses considered, because you marry the lens, you date the body, okay? So you the lenses that you buy start to become a collection, and therefore when you start looking at a camera that comes over from, let's say, Sony or maybe someplace else, your eyes, it's like eye candy, and you go like, I want to have one of those. And the truth of the fact is, you've got all Canon lenses, or you've got all Nikon lenses. So that's why I said the first thing first is, if you actually own Canon lenses, you need to be looking at the Canon cameras first, unless you're willing to make a complete and total jump right out of the Canon camera line into something else. So here's the drum roll. I would actually choose the Nikon ZFC. They're similar priced. The Nikon ZFC body only is about $950, $960. You can see I did write the link to the camera in the description below. So like I said, if you want to read and click on it, it's down there. So I would choose the Nikon ZFC over the Canon 90D. Canon 90D body only is going to be like $1,200. I believe it's $1,199. And the Nikon ZFC is $950 something. I want to say $956, but I'm not quite sure. So I'm looking for cues. Randy is saying here, okay, Randy is my moderator. Hi, Randy, how you doing? If you have any questions, type QQQ so he will answer your question. I'm looking for the QQQ, okay? So please help me. Help me, number one, stay on track. Help me by not asking questions that's not pertaining to the Nikon or the Canon, because I like to do rabbit trails. It's my fault, it's not yours, okay? And I don't stay on track. So I want to stay on track. So now I just switch the camera over to the Nikon ZFC. So I'm looking, we got a QQQ from Anthony. He's saying, any suggestions? I'm replacing my M50 to go along with my R. If you've got those lenses will not fit on your 90D. Anthony, I know, is another friend, okay? So Anthony, none of those lenses would fit, but I feel honestly, you would totally actually love the Nikon ZFC, and that could stay and do your family business for a very, very long time. So I would recommend the Nikon ZFC over the Canon 90D. My personal recommendation, though, you don't have to go with my recommendation just because I said it. You do your own shopping. You listen and follow other people and see what they've got to say. Okay. So that was Anthony. All right. We got Woody. Woody is in the house. Hi, Woody. Happy Sunday night, buddy. It is 9 p.m. time for the Peter Gregg Live Show, the 9 p.m. Sunday nights. QQQ. Woody says, it looks like the Canon is holding focus so far, much better than Friday. So Woody was here Friday night. Man, I've got to tell you, that camera would not stay on my face. Let's go back over to it. Okay, so I did go in and I did check all the menus and set it to face tracking. And the one change that I made from Friday, which was terrible, I was actually embarrassed for the Canon 90D. That's how poorly it did. So it just kept coming in and out. So what I did was I changed the responsiveness from really fast, because like Italians, I'm Greek. My hands go around and do like that, you know, because, you guys on the podcast, I am making all kind of Italian gesticulations with my hands. They are flapping around. And Friday night, the Canon 90D was just like, bam. It just decided, to heck with you, Peter. I'm going to focus on the background. So let's do that walk of focus again. I'm going to put the hands up, turn my back to the camera, and then walk back here. I'm going to do a little swing around. Now it's got the side. And then I'm going to face the camera. And now I'm about 12 to 14 feet from the Christmas desk. Okay. Now I'm going to walk over to Jingle's chair. This is Jingle's chair. Okay, now, here's the problem. We got Christmas lights going on here, but it's looking for a face, but Myrtle, the microphone, is sitting. Can you see her blurred out? So the Canon 90D might get attracted to Myrtle and jump off of me. So if you see Myrtle go into focus, okay, you'll know what happened. I just took one step forward. I'm trying to trip this up, okay? You see my head is hiding under the Canon 90D label? By the way, guys, I put labels up here so you know what camera is actually being shown. And I do that for the live show, and I do that for my pre-recorded shows, which I put up. And yes, I still do pre-recorded shows here. I'm not switching over completely to live. So now I walk back up to the Christmas desk. I'm going to turn around. Hello, wall. How boring thy looketh. And now I'm going to turn my face. So now it has eyes. And remember, glasses also have a tendency to trip up the cameras. and you put the glasses on, and suddenly sometimes you can't see your eyes, or there's a glare. And that's what we've got going on. So I'm going to set the cameras here to automatically rotate. All right, and we'll start off with the ZFC. So the ZFC's got a 35 millimeter 1.8 lens on here. Here's the surprise. Surprise, okay. The lens that you're looking is not a native Nikon lens. This is kind of a little bit of a rabbit trail, okay. Now this is the big boy in here. This is the grandpa. This is the Nikon Z6. This is not the Z6 Mark II. This is the original Z6, but it does have the new firmware that's been out about almost a year now, which has made this camera not bulletproof, but very, very close to bulletproof in terms of focusing, coloring, okay? Now, just by looking at my monitor, which is calibrated compared to your monitor, if you're on a phone, if you're on a computer, if you're on a monitor, a computer monitor, an iPad, I watch a lot of my YouTube videos on the iPad, all right? You can kind of pay attention to the face coloring. I know it's not the best face that you've ever seen, all right, but it's the only one that I got, and this is what we're doing. So, yes, Woody, to answer your QQQ question, thank you for putting QQQ in there. And, yeah, it does look like it's holding up better with that actually was going. So now we have Randall. Last time you had the Louise microphone with the 90D. With Myrtle, Mike, it is doing better. I got a little secret to share with you, Randy, okay? On Friday night, I had the cable plugged into this microphone, but the actual microphone that was plugged in to the Mac Mini was not the correct microphone. It was the microphone that I sing at on my desk, which, let's do a little business here. Let's pay some bills, okay? First of all, thank you for any of the super chats. I appreciate it. Oh, I see one. Let's go to the super chat immediately. Sammy. Let's see if I can get you up here. Sammy. There we go. Super chat. $10 from Sammy. Thank you very much, Sammy. You are a blessing tonight, young man. I appreciate it. Are you using the 4K on the 90D? Maybe the Canon in 4K. You might not have the full autofocus when you're in full K mode or HDMI. All right, well, it does give you full autofocus. Yes, everything here tonight is in 4K. So I actually have 1, 2, 3, 4 cameras operating. All four of them are in 4K. I'm using Ecamm Live software, which is the software I've been using for almost 2 years now. Just a month short of 2 years, right when they first started, I made friends with Glenn and Ken, and there was actually a problem just this last week, and I was conversing with Glenn. He's very responsive and actually solved the problem that I'm having. The fix isn't in yet, but he's identified it. And identifying your problem is 99% of the way towards getting your problem fixed. So thank you to Sammy. And let's see, there's a Brandon is asking, I see the QQQ. Thank you, Brandon. Thank you for respecting the QQQ. I'm not trying to be silly, guys, but I do happen to miss some of the questions. So since the monitor that I'm watching is over on the wall, my eyes are scanning for a QQQ. And you do need, your question does need to be pertaining to the 90D or to the ZFC. So, Brandon, you came and went so soon. Let's get back on it. Any focus issues with the Nikon? Here's the deal. I have been running, I'm talking to you, Brandon, so even though I get a little blabbery here for a second or so, I have been running the Nikon ZFC, which I have, lovingly named it the KFC, because every time I say ZFC, I feel like a piece of extra crispy Kentucky Fried Chicken. So I might say KFC by accident. It started out as a joke, but somehow it's gotten down into my brain and it's staying stuck. So I really do mean the ZFC, okay? So the ZFC is here from the from B&H, and so is the 90D. So those cameras don't technically belong to me. They're on, let's call it a loan. I have something going on with B&H and I get cameras in here. And then they go back. They don't give me the cameras to keep. So people go like, Peter, you have so many cameras. Well, I do have a lot of cameras, but the ones that are making it live need to be 4K. And all my cameras, sometimes they're older, I don't have 4K. So this guy here I own. And for you guys that are on the podcast, I am showing a picture now that's coming 4K through the Mac Mini M1, the new chip. That was the Z6. So now I'm on the ZFC, the KFC, and the camera body and the lens is native to each other. The 35mm lens is the Nikon Z mount. Okay, actually they call it an S mount, but it's a Z lens. Don't ask, Nikon's got a little bit of things screwed up in their head. It's a CS mount, but they call it a Z lens, okay? Should have been a Z mount, okay? Whatever, I don't run Nikon, but I want them to succeed because I own them, all right? So what I'm trying to get to here, Brandon, is something important. Pay attention. I promise it's important if I can get it to come out of my mouth, all right? Tonight, I'm doing something different. I am not running the original native lens that's made by Nikon for the Nikon ZFC camera. I'm running a different lens, one of the very, very few lenses you can actually purchase, buy, put money down on the table for, that actually is the native ZFC mount, meaning it's not running a, an adapter. Because you could buy the adapter and you could put hundreds and hundreds of Nikon lenses. So this is a Viltrox lens, V-I-L-T-R-O-X. I wrote it in the doobly-doo, so if you want to see what I diddly did, I learned that, so you're going to have to humor me tonight. You can look down there. Now, what's the game to fame for the Viltrox? So the Viltrox lens is a 35mm 1.8 Z lens, no adapter. Does it do autofocus? Yes, it does. As soon as the automatic changes that are happening through the Ecamm Live software, which is what runs the show here, as soon as we get back over there, just know that you are watching a lens. Now you're watching it. This is the Viltrox 35mm f1.8 Z mount, meaning it's native to this camera. Let's do the walk of focus. I'm going to turn around. I'm no face involved, which is why I turn around. I wave my hands. Okay, now I'm going to walk back, and I'm going to walk over to the Jingle Bells' chair. Okay, so no, I need to put the camera on. We need to stop rotating cameras and put the camera on because this is kind of important. Okay, so let's click here. That's the wrong camera, Peter. We'll click here. Okay. Now I'm going to turn around. I'm going to do the hand wave. There's no eyeballs. That's the reason I turn around and stop, okay? Because the original Nikon firmware for the old Nikon cameras, they would continue on and focus to the tree, all right? So now I'm over to Jingle Bells' chair. This is the 35mm 1.8 set to 1.8 Viltrox lens. It's new. I don't think it's been on the market more than a few weeks, maybe a month or two. I'm not sure when it came out, but it just came up on B&H because I was just speaking with them and they told me we have a new lens for the Nikon ZFC. I said, do tell. I would like to hear about this new lens. So what really caught my attention was that it's $400. Okay, I'm sorry, but it's $850 to buy the same exact lens, meaning 35mm 1.8 Z mount lens. It's $850 to get a native lens. Or you can go with an adapter and then you can put any of the other Nikon lenses, which will lower your price. However, this is more than half the price. I actually paid, I bought this lens. This lens is mine. And I have a ZFC coming to me. I decided to purchase one, but Randy, who is our moderator tonight, said, Peter, for your birthday, I'm sending you a brand spanking new ZFC camera. Happy birthday, Peter. Wow. That's the kind of friends you want, right? So Randy sent it. It's not here yet. It should be coming in next week. But I don't have a native Z lens to put on the camera that's coming. So I'll have a camera in hand with no Z lens or any lens to put on it. So I was about to make a purchase at B&H, and then I was told, wait, hold on there, Charlie. There's a new lens in town, and it's from Viltrox, V-I-L-T-R-O-X. The link is in the thing down below, the description, okay? Yes, I get feedback, and I get credit when you buy it through that link. So can I ask you to please do that? Okay, so I was able to get that lens just as it hit the street. I bet you dollar to donuts, this lens is going to get sucked out of being in stock, because for $399, golly gee whiz, Batman, you know, how bad could it be? And if you look over a fellow YouTube content creator, Richard Wong, did a complete test with the lens and sold. Okay, it did a great job for him. So now I'm going to walk around a little bit. I'm going to stand underneath my hair light. See how I became an angel all of a sudden? But if I stand in the right place, my face will still be lit up properly. So this is a Viltrox. This is not a Nikon brand. Make sure you understand that, okay? It's not a Nikon lens on the Nikon camera. It's a Viltrox lens on the Nikon camera. And so what's the big deal, Peter? $400. This lens is $399, and the Nikon lens is $859. Okay, so Nikon makes money on their lenses, and rightly so. They engineered it, okay, and it, you know, they deserve to make the money. But just the standard 1.8 lens at $859, okay, that's a little bit of highway robbery, all right? So, but that's my opinion. Obviously, my opinion doesn't count because that's what's out on the market. So is this lens as good as the Nikon? Well, I'll tell you this much. I have not been disappointed in it. It just arrived this morning. So I've had one whole day, big deal, all right? And I can tell you that it actually, I'm very happy with what I'm seeing. I haven't done lab tests, so I don't know if the very corners over here are as sharp as my nose over here, okay? Those will come out. So the short answer to your question, Brandon, I haven't found any issues yet. I haven't seen it trip up. It will, okay? And so on and so forth. Julio, how you doing, Julio? Thank you for coming in. Julio's got a question. It seems that the Nikon has better color rendition than the Canon. I would agree with you on that also. Both of them are color tuned. So how did you color tune, Peter? Okay, is this arbitrary? You just did a bad job on the Canon compared to the Nikon? No. I use the X-Rite Color Checker Passport. This opens up. It gives me the color palette. I do a few seconds, if I can get it straight. I do a few seconds. I actually do it like this, okay? I do a few seconds of recording and save it. And then I do the same thing on the Canon. Then I take it into Final Cut Pro, where I have a program called Color Finale, like final with an E, Color Finale, okay? And there's four little, let me turn on the hand camera. I forgot to turn that one on so I could show you this thing so you could see how I set up the color balance, okay? And then you can determine, hey, Peter, you're cheated, or Peter, you did a good job. Okay, so let's go over here, and now I've got my ZV-1, which is another, it's a hand camera. All right, now let me turn on the ZV-1 so I can show you the okay, so this is what the X-Rite color checker looks like. Now, if you carefully look in the corners, you'll see like little corner markings, like crop marks. You see the crop marks? There's one in this corner, there's one in this corner, and then on the opposite side is the same thing. All right, so inside of Color Finale, you set up where each corner clicks, you click on each corner and it identifies the entire color checker. And after it identifies the entire color checker, you push a button and it actually, it just creates a LUT for you. It creates a profile that you're able to use right off the bat, and you do no color correction. You don't start changing the reds, you don't start changing the greens. Okay, see in the back, the LED lights, I'll go back there so you can see them, okay? So those LED lights that are on the wall back there between the tree and this bubble lamp right here, those are blue. Beautiful baby blue, like my blue eyes, all right? Now, with this color checker, I did the same thing for this camera. I did the same exact thing for this camera, okay, which is the Nikon Z6, and I did exactly the same thing for the ZFC. So it's not by my eyes. In other words, don't be hammering on me. You didn't color correct it correctly. I use the color passport, okay? Now, I do not have the link to this in the doobly-doo, but I think I should put it down there, all right? So you guys that are on the podcast, I just showed, I know you can't see the pictures, but because I'm broadcasting this live on YouTube, I just showed how I set up the color balance so that it is not arbitrary and it's not just to my eyes, but it is calculated by the computer inside of Final Cut Pro, which you can do, use Color Finale in there. I'm not sure which other platforms it's for. Okay, so if you don't like the colors, both cameras are actually set up to be neutral, and the sharpness is smack in the middle, and the color is set to 2800 because I got 2750 light bulbs in all of the soft boxes that are going on in the room. So that's what you're looking at, okay? And next QQQ, I see the QQQ, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. John, how you doing, John Drummond? I so enjoy you when I watch you live and I watch you on YouTube. The ZFC has no grip. How comfortable is it to hold for extended periods? Okay, two things. It's comfortable, it's not as comfortable as the Canon 90D. The Canon 90D is much more comfortable. However, I was just sent, and it came in Saturday night. Let's see if I can find it. I was just sent a grip that's custom made just for the Nikon ZFC. And this is from Small Rig. Where am I? Over here. Okay. Let's see if I can unwrap this. I'm going to do a video on this. I'm going to pull it out of the box. I'm going to put it on the camera and show you, okay? So this is from Small Rig, which is a company. I have Small Rig stuff on my Sony camera gear, and they make very, very good additions and stuff. This is the A7S Mark III, which is on Facebook for sale. I'm selling this to free up some money, and that is because I'm trying to get the CD out, the Christmas CD, okay? And all right, so this grip is designed, let's switch over to that close-up camera again. This grip is designed to go on the bottom. It screws in here. It's all one piece, okay? And it's got a tripod screw. Let's see if I can get this a little closer so you can see the bottom. Okay, you guys that are really into cameras, this is important. See, I'm going to change the angle. See, it's got the tripod screw plus the big screw, which is right here in the middle. That goes in the tripod hole. But if you use that, you lose your tripod screw. So right beneath it is a tripod screw. This is all metal, okay? And they've got a very nice grip. I can use this grip without a camera. I can pretend I'm taking pictures of you. So that is a new addition, but I want to do a proper unboxing and show this on the camera. It's got a little bit of a grippy thing here, so the camera won't rotate. It's got a lip, so the camera will sit in right into it like a sleeve, Okay, it's got the hole here to access the batteries. Let's go from the inside, see? So they access the battery, and everything else is open. And this is molded. This is a rubbery grip, so it should stay in place. I will show you in a separate recorded video, not live, all right, because I'm going to have to take the tripod, the camera off the tripod and show. So this week, I will make a video. I was kind of waiting for my new ZFC, the one that Randy's sending here, to come in, because I want to put this on that camera. So you guys got a quick sneak peek at the new grip from Small Rig. And I'm closing this up. There we go. Nope, this goes out here. Okay, so let's put this over here. So that should address the grip for you, John. It should make it much more to what we're comfortable with looking at and feeling. And I'll let you know. So watch for the video this week. I guess it would be a good place to say, if you're not subscribed, please subscribe. Okay. So now I'm scrolling down. I'm looking if any more QQQs are there. So this way I will come in. Charles has a QQQ. The Viltrox lenses are superb. I have three of the Viltrox lenses for Fujifilm cameras. They are very, very well built. And that brings up a new question. I did have the Viltrox lenses in here for the Fuji camera that I had in here, but it was about a year ago, okay? So things could have changed. The Viltrox lens actually did better on the Fujifilm cameras than Fujifilm's own lens. So surprise, all right? But Fujifilm is, even though they have a camera in this price range, someone might ask, a Fuji person might say, Peter, why don't you recommend the Fuji camera? And my response would be is I've had them all the way up to the X-T4 in here. And no, I would not recommend the Fuji camera to the general public. The Fujifilm camera is a wonderful camera. It's very solid. It performs really well, but it's got its different quirks. It doesn't have the lens array that we have available from Canon and Nikon. And it's more of a niche camera for a niche market. So if one of my friends that would be like a couple, a husband and a wife, and maybe they got a child, or there's a child on the way, or they might have a teenage girl or a teenage boy, and they're interested in making family pictures. So, you know, the Fuji guy that loves the Fuji, you know, they're rooting for the Fuji team. Go Fuji, go Fuji. You know, this is almost like a sports game, okay? And they're going like, well, why aren't you recommending the Fuji, Peter? And I'm not. You want to know about the Fuji? Actually, Charles, that you just saw, is very much into Fuji. If he's going to say anything out of his mouth, you watch. 9 times out of 10, Charles will say something about the Fuji camera. So you would go to his channel. And yes, Charles has a channel. Look in the comments. Look for his name, Charles Richard. Go to his channel, and you can see him do live shows with his Fuji camera. Okay, now I'm sure he's not pleased because I'm saying, no, I am not recommending the Fuji camera. I'm not recommending the Panasonic camera. I'm not recommending the Olympus camera. The Sony camera would be a camera I could recommend, and I've got one coming in. I've got one coming in that's right around $800 or less. So we're going to have another one of these playoffs. We're going to have it the ZFC against, let's say, the Sony ZV-E10, which now their pricing is in the similar market. I don't have that camera, but the two of the big names is Canon. Bing! Out of 100 cameras sold today, 45 of them will be Canons. Okay? 22 of them will be Sonys. 12 of them will be Nikon. So Sony actually has surpassed Nikon. However, Nikon has finally come to the game, and they have the ZFC, and Peter likes it. As a matter of fact, I got me one. It's on its way here, and I've got the Viltrox lens on it right now. So let's go and find some more QQQs, so this way I can get the questions answered. Let's see. Charles says, I have a spoiler for you. The Canon 90D cannot reproduce proper color for the LED lights. Wow. all of us have been watching that happen now for a few months. The Canon cameras keep reproducing the LEDs in the back on the wall, right above my thumb, right there. Purple. It keeps making them purple. Does the ZFC do that? Let's find out. Let's see if the ZFC. By golly, the Nikon ZFC, my Kentucky Fried Chicken camera, if I don't break this arm, those LEDs at the top of my tongue are blue. That's the actual color of them. And my shirt is red. It's the actual color. So in terms of coloring, I would have to say that the Nikon wins. And that's why I decided to buy, and now it's being given to me by Randy. The ZFC is joining the Christmas room. It's going to have its own place right there. And then I have a couple of more places for cameras that are going to be guest cameras, because I get other cameras from different people. So thank Sammy. Did I thank you for the super chat? Sammy, go to petergregg.com, P-R-E-G-G.com. And when you go there, you'll see in the top left quadrant, there's a picture of the new CD that I've got coming out. The CD will be put up for pre-sale this Wednesday, my birthday, October 13th. Happy birthday to me, yes sir-ree. Okay, so October 13th, it's going to get opened. It's got a timer in there for pre-sales, and people can pre-order the camera. Yeah, it's a camera. No, it's a CD. This is a friend of mine CD, okay? But the picture that's going to go on the front, if you want to see what kind of a picture did you make for your CD, Peter, go to petergregg.com. You find the CD, click on the CD. Use the mouse, use the finger. You guys that are listening to the podcast, use the mouse, use the finger, go to petergregg.com. You'll see what the cover of my CD will look like. You'll see the title of it. You'll even see my mug on the face, okay? And if you scroll down just a little bit lower, you'll see the songs that are on there. Now, here's the clue, okay? I'm transparent. I'm being open with everybody. The songs that are in green font, the font is green, are songs that I have done. They're completed. They're ready at the CD company, ready to press. I got two more songs, and they would be in black, meaning they're not done. So, Sammy, since you put in a super chat, I want to give you a gift back, Sammy. You listening, Sam? Okay, so go over to petergregg.com, click on the CD. You'll open up a new page. Look at the names of the songs. Email me with my emails in the description down below with what song you like. You can have one free song, Sammy. You gave me the super chat. I want to thank you better than just thank you for the super chat, okay? Anybody else that gives a super chat tonight, I'm going to give you one free song, okay? $5 or more on the super chats, okay? And you can get your choice. Any of the songs that's green are ready. They are cooked. They're baked. They've come out of the oven. They've cooled off. Okay, I do some cooking in case you can't tell. And you can get your own free one. Okay. So, Sammy, pick out the song that you'd like and email me by email. The link is in the thing down below, and I will send it to you. So we've got Welcome to the Joneses, which is a YouTube channel in its own. And his name is Anthony. I happen to know who he is. And he says, Peter, I'm stuck in the Canon system because I've hugely invested in RF lenses. That said, the ZFC is mirrorless. Any thoughts on comparing to the RP? I want to finish your sentence, okay? Or wait until Canon comes up with something. All right, now, because you said the word hugely, I'm not looking to upset your wallet, Anthony, so I would say you need to try everything that you can try to stay in the Canon line because the RF lenses are very nice, sharp lenses. I mean, Canon is doing a bang-up job on quality with the R-mount lenses that they've got, okay? So it's called the RF mount. because what's on the 90D here is not the RF mount, that is the EF mount. And the EF mount has been around for ages. You could buy any EF mount, even from Sigma, even from Tamron. If it's an EF mount, it's going to fit on this Canon 90D. That's an advantage, okay? So, Anthony, since you have a lot of those lenses, my guess is they're not going to leave the people that own the 90D in a lurch. So the problem is the shortages of stuff. The shortages are keeping camera companies from releasing stuff. They can't build them. They can't get this chip. They can't get that part because there's shortages. Now, how all these shortages are working, I'm not quite so sure. Okay. Because we got, excuse me, more than just shortages, we also have shipping problems happening. Okay, so you've got shipping problems, you've got shortages of chips, Tesla, which I'm very big a fan of Tesla, has got their own shortages, so they're trying to get cars out the door, camera companies are trying to get cameras out the door, so... Anthony, I would be watching because we're in that zone and we're about to leave it because camera companies have already positioned themselves for what's going to be sold is already there because we got Christmas coming up. When do most of the sales happen? Most of the sales happen for Christmas, which is why I'm rushing to get the Christmas CD done. So for my birthday, which is Wednesday, I'm opening up the pre-sale. So the CD is not going to be available on Wednesday. All right. The CD should get pressed and get to me by maybe the first or second week of November because they take like 3 weeks. And if they're late, people are late sometimes. Okay. So by the second week in the second week of November, that is when I expect to get the CDs in hand and we'll be popping them in the mail to mail them out. Now, before that, I will have all the songs done, so for that price, you'll also get all the files, the downloads, for all those songs. And you're not going to wait that long for that, because in order for me to ship out everything to get the CD done, the songs have to be done. So you get the free download, okay, you get the CD mailed, and it's in the U.S., it's going to get mailed for free. The shipping is free. There is an additional charge for overseas, because it costs, you know, whatever it is, I think it's between $8 and $9. So the price of the CD, let's say if you're in England or Romania or in Spain or in Australia or in Canada, is going to have that added, let's just say $8.50, because I don't remember what it is, okay? So it's better off me not opening my mouth and sticking my foot in it. So starting Wednesday, you can pre-order. And I do appreciate those pre-orders because that's what's going to help pay to get the rest of this stuff done. So don't think by pre-ordering, you know, I'm not very grateful. I am. All right. So let's go on. And I am looking for QQQs. I see a lot of you just to say hello to a few. I see Charles, Sammy, Randy, Eric. Peter's my buddy, he's my nutritionist, John Drummond, they're all saying something and saying hello, so I just want to acknowledge him, but I will very much get off the track if I start doing that, and I will get a lot of people unsubscribing because it's like, you can't even put on a proper live show. So I'm trying really hard, don't unsubscribe, I'm asking you, please subscribe if you're new. So, here we go. I don't see any more QQQs. Good. I don't want to miss anyone. Up, Randy. Randy, my moderator has a question from Tommy Young. Okay, so maybe I missed one. Okay, thank you, Randy. Randy keeps me in line, too. So, question from Tommy Young. Hi, Tommy. How does the 90D have a focus stacking mode inside the camera? No, I don't believe it's got focus stacking in the 90D. That would possibly, if Canon decides to put that feature in something at this price range, Canon is more sensitive to price range. Okay, they don't like you to buy a hamburger and they're going to deliver you a nice steak. That's not Canon. Canon is a very much what you get what you pay for and no more, okay? Sony doesn't follow that track. Sony says, we'll give you the hamburger and we'll give you a little piece of steak too. Maybe not the whole steak, but a little bit more, okay? So it's important. And, that you realize that some features are just not gonna make it in the $1,000 to $1,500 price range. It just, Canon just ain't gonna do it. I can't fault them for it either, all right? I can just tell you that some other camera companies, let's go over to the ZFC for a little bit, okay, so you can see the difference, all right? I do notice that the ZFC is friendlier with my skin tone. So at my age, this is 68. Happy birthday to me on Wednesday, okay? And we've got the Joneses. Anthony, happy birthday. I celebrated my 51st. Oh, happy birthday, Anthony, but I'm not gonna go sidetrack. Let's do that Friday night. And I will actually take the microphone on Friday night live and I will sing happy birthday to you, but not on the big channel here because I wanna stay on track. All right, so I think the skin coloring, I think they might do something to push the midtones in its natural makeup of the camera, the algorithms and stuff, because if I compare my face on this camera, let's say to the Canon 90D, okay, personally, you know, everybody's got eyes here, okay, except you guys that are on the podcast, you can't tell. I'm showing my face, all right? So showing my face. So this is what my face looks like on the Canon 90D. So because of my age, I also did bump my head right here. It was bleeding all the way down into my eye area. So I put a little bit of skin moisturizer on there that's got a little color to it, like when, you know, the suntan lotion that's got some color to it. So it doesn't look so blaringly red because it's like really, really bad. All right, yeah, a lot of blood there. So this is what my skin tones look on the 90D. You have to be the judge. I get to be the judge on my own. My skin colors here versus my skin colors here. Now you're gonna have to say, which one do you like better? I could tell you from what I'm looking at, my skin colors actually look better on the ZFC. And I know this is not part of it, okay? But I'm going to add the Z6. Because you can get the Z6 as low as $1,300, all right? Doesn't have a flippy screen, but it is a full frame camera. So Anthony, you know, I know you're so embedded right into that Canon and you're just gonna have to wait and see what they do to give you something that would be, you know, comparable in the $1,300 to $1,500 range. No, the RP is not, it would not be my choice. Okay, if you had to buy it and you can't live without it for the moment, okay, it would be kind of like getting the Canon RP. It would kind of like be getting a full frame camera for pictures, but like a Sony ZV-1, which is this one, because of the crop, if you go to 4K, okay, so this is a 1-inch sensor. This is my hand cam, okay? This is the ZV-1. You could tell up in the corner, upper right hand corner of the screen, what camera that is. So let's go back to the Z. Let's go back to the ZFC. So John is asking a question. Hi, John. Pertaining to the 90D, RP, and R5, R6, all have automated focus bracketing modes, but I believe not in the R. So that might be helpful for you, Anthony. John is telling you that those focus bracketing modes are not there. So let's go back down. Randy says, General One asked this question. Gosh, how I'm missing these. How come it's not coming up? Thank you, Randy. God bless you, dude. Does the 90D suffer from sharpness from the STM lenses? Canon said, do megapixel sensor better K series. Let's read that again. Gosh. Okay, so the Canon said, due to the megapixel sensor, is better. I don't know what a K series glass. We don't have K series glass on the Canon. Okay, so Nixon says, QQQ, Nixon. Okay, the 90D Focus has bracketing, but not focus stacking. Okay, yes, I agree. Did I say it wrong? I thought the question was about focus stacking, not bracketing. Okay, so if you asked about focus bracketing, yeah, the 90D does have that. The focus stacking, it does not have that. And that's when I started talking about what features we actually get and which we don't get. All right, so let's see. Randy, if they're not putting QQQs in, I'm not reading them. My eyes don't go to them. So I notice you're picking out questions where, like, General One did not put a QQQ. It's right up here, okay? But there's no QQQ, so my eyes are looking for the QQQs, just so you understand what's happening in my brain, okay? If you want to ask me a question, guys, the screen is like 6 feet away from me. So I need to find the QQQ to click on you to see the question. So if you just ask a question and it doesn't have a QQQ, even though it's pertaining to the 90D, I'm not being mean. I can't see it. And yes, I have my glasses on. My birthday is Wednesday. Happy birthday. My eyesight, oh, it ain't so good as it used to be. So I'm looking for QQQs. So don't be just asking questions, you know, about the 90D, and don't start it with a capital QQQ, because I'm looking for those. I could see them. Okay, Nixon, I was able to see his. Nixon has been here for so long. God bless you, Nixon. I haven't seen you in quite a while. So thank you for coming in tonight, by the way. He used to come to the live shows all the time. So I guess I got boring. So I can get boring, all right? So he's got a QQQ. I could see that. So we're about at the end of the show. It's almost an hour. But if you do have a question, put it in now. Is the QQQ, I could still see it. Like Randy says, if you have a question, put a QQQ in front of it, and it needs to be pertaining to the 90D. The QQQ does not give you an automatic pass to tell me how handsome I look or happy birthday. I have to stay on track. So going back to the birthday, yes, it is on track, because that is how we are actually going to pay some bills. So on Wednesday, it opens up where you can actually pre-order the CD. If you're inclined to do that, do it on my birthday. That's what I'm asking you to do. Do it on my birthday. You'll be able to buy it all of October, all of November, all of December. So it's not a big deal, okay? But it's my birthday on Wednesday, and it's a big deal for me, not for you, okay? So it's happy birthday to me. So if you want to give me a good pat on the back, go pre-order it on Wednesday, where you can pre-order it. Charles has got a QQQ. Hi, Charles. How you doing, buddy? The Nikon and Canon weather resistant. The Canon is not, but I do notice a rubber gasket for the ZFC. But I haven't noticed specifically if the camera is listed as weather resistant. At $956, I would be inclined to say no. However, Nikon is putting in some really good features that go in higher priced cameras. Canon has been very reluctant to do that. So General One, let's see, he has the question I left. Does the Canon 90D suffer from sharpness due to higher megapixel size with the Canon STM lenses? I read an article that said that this Canon required L glass. Well, the 90, and any camera, okay, does better with the better quality glass. But I have some cheapies that do great. So what happens is, on a cheaper lens, they make it cheaper by cutting corners. It's not just cheaper because somebody decides, well, it costs us $600 for the lens, so we're going to sell it for $1,200, and we'll make double our money when we make lenses. That's not how it's decided. It's more decided like, it costs us $600 to make this lens, okay, including research and development. Then they step forward and price it. So when they want to lower the price, what are they going to look at to bring the price lower? So it'll be the materials. The lens might not be metal. It might be plastic, and plastics have a different grade of plastics. They've got plastics in airplanes, jets, okay, that are designed stronger than metal. All right. So that is where they start looking, so they can lower the price. The other major area that they start looking at to lower the price is they work on center sharpness. So yeah, by golly, the center is sharper. Now, I'm on the Viltrox, which is a low price lens. So let me go over. Okay. Now I'm looking directly into it. How much duller do I look? I am giving you this in 4K. The Mac Mini M1 is in 4K. Ecamm is set to 4K. You can click on that little gear and you can confirm that you're watching 4K. So this is how the sharpness is on a $400 lens, $399, compared to Nikon's $800 lens. So do I look terribly out of focus if I did the whole show sitting here and I had another guest over here? Now, when I come to the center, all right, the lenses are designed to be sharp in the center. So that's one of the areas where they lower the price by lowering the quality in that. Okay. So that was your answer. Randy says that the ZFC is not listed as being weather resistant. Sammy's put a QQQ. If you shot a music video for your new album, would you use the ZFC or another camera? I would probably, Sammy, to answer your question, I would use the Kentucky Fried Chicken camera, the ZFC, because I like the way it looks, but I wouldn't do the whole thing with one camera. You notice when I turn on the rotating cameras, I've got four or five cameras that we rotate through, and they're all labeled up here. So the key for that, for everybody else, you guys that are on the podcast, you're not going to see this part, all right? But the labels in red mean the cameras are not rotating. If I go over to the rotating cameras, look what happens to the labels up in the corner, okay? The labels turn black. So that's like a cue to me, my own QQQ, okay, that a black means this camera is going to rotate. So I need to pay attention that the computer is going to change the camera like it just did. And I will just casually, nonchalantly just slide over to that camera, okay? So that is being handled by Ecamm. Ecamm is in the link down below. It's a Mac-only software, but darn if it don't work good. It really works good. So Randy says that the ZFC is not weather-resistant. Okay, that's important. I do see another QQQ. Eric, I heard the 90D was weather-sealed. Canon is touting it is. All right, if you actually look on their website, let me know. I don't know. If it's not listed in the features, I don't want to pass on the wrong information. Okay. So we got a super chat from Carlos. How are you doing, Carlos? It's so good to see you. $20. Thank you, Carlos. I appreciate that so much. And you know what, Carlos? Send me an email. It's in the description down below. And pick out a song that is green, because I got those done. I can't send you a song I haven't finished. And I'll just send it to you as a free gift to say thank you. Thank you so much for the super chat. Now, I know there was probably a question in there somewhere, so let's do the question. Carlos, hi Peter, how does the dynamic range differ on the ZFC versus the 90D? Does the Nikon use something similar to Canon log? They don't give you the log on the ZFC like Canon, and not only that, you've got third party that you can add into the Canon. I forgot who it is. I think he's in England, but he sells one, and I did buy it, and it was good. So the Nikon, that's one of the areas where they actually might have skimped. Now, if you want to see the actual feature for feature, click on the link in down below in the description, and click on the link to B&H, because they will have the specs listed there. And not only that, you'll also get comments. This is a show where I'm giving the show, okay? So you'll have comments from a lot of different people when you click on the B&H link. And I do read the comments. That's why I almost didn't buy the Viltrox lens. Some of the Viltrox lenses have bad comments. And I'm going like, uh-oh, this is going to be a problem. I'm going to need to spend $800 and go with the Nikon Z-mount lens. But then I saw Richard Wong, and he got one of these lenses in also, and he did a video where he's showing it. I'm doing a video. I'm going to do a video this week where I just feature that lens straight through the video, so this way people can go and reference it, because people want to see before they buy, is this going to work for me or it's not going to work for me? So why would you buy it if it's not going to work for you? That's like the Samyang lens. On the Sony, doesn't work very good for video focus. Single shot focus is a different story. So I do see some questions in there that I really would like to answer, but please put a QQQ so I can notice them. Okay, so Ed, I just happened to see anti-alias filter, and I'm going like, what is he asking? If you put a QQQ in there, Ed, it'll help me a lot. I'm not being an ASS, I just need to be able to see that the questions are coming in. All right, so yes, Canon believes very much in anti-alias filters, and the Nikon does not, and Sony definitely does not. Okay, so that's a very important question. We got Aaron Short. Aaron Short is a world-famous musician, and he's giving a $10 super chat. Thank you. Happy birthday, Peter. Have some chicken on me. You will enjoy it. The chicken, not so much. That's a Norm joke for you guys that are in on Friday night. Norm says something like, we had chicken for dinner. We enjoyed the dinner very much. The chicken, not so much. In other words, they ate the chicken. All right. Thank you, Aaron. Go in the description. Go to petergregg.com. Pick out a song, and I'll email it to you. So Randy is saying that the ZFC has no alias filter, so thank you for confirming that. I am looking for a QQQ, and I don't see any. So that brings us close to the end of the show. That doesn't mean leave, okay, because I got something to say. I still have something to say. So if you have no lenses and you want a solid camera that you can pick up and work easily, pick on the spot where you want to focus, tap on the back, and it'll go there. If you want to tap on a person, it'll go and lock in on that person. If you want good color rendering, then I suggest this camera. That would be my recommendation, because I know it will work for you and it will work well. All right. Now, if you're a Canon fan, don't get all flustered. Canon hasn't entered into this market yet in a way where it's credible. They put out the RP and the R, and they're more for cameras that know how to work that particular camera. But for the general public that wants to buy a camera, just have it work well. Just come home with nice pictures. Get really good video of whatever it is you're videoing. You can be videoing yourself for your own YouTube channel, which has become very popular. Then my recommendation is all the cameras out there would be the ZFC. And the only other one that would enter into that arena would be the Sony E10, which we will do a video on that when I get that camera in here. Because, I don't know, maybe the E10 would beat out over the ZFC, which is what you're watching now. But until I get the camera here, I can't put them side by side, so you can make your own choices. So if you guys would like to subscribe so you can get the videos that I put on during the week between my Sunday night 9 p.m. live shows, subscribe to the channel, okay? If you're upset because I'm not doing a video where it's pre-recorded, those I will put up during the week. So you don't have to leave, you don't have to unsubscribe, you will still get your videos, but I enjoy the interaction that we have live. I get to see the questions. I get to see what you're saying. Okay, and I appreciate you. And you get to say happy birthday to me. Wednesday, October 13th, it will open up where you can pre-order. The CD is not going to go out until November, all right? But as soon as I get all the files, I will email all the files for the songs straight to your email box. And that's about it. So, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida, please subscribe. I'm asking for subscriptions. And thank you all for being here tonight. Good night, everybody. I appreciate you coming and spending your Sunday night with me. God bless you. Bye-bye.